Zuri l-Pavi Supermarket u barra minn għażla kbira ta' prodotti rinomati tgawdi wkoll minn aktar minn 800 prodott b'offerta speċjali kuljum.
Pavi, where everyone loves to shop.
Dan u l-akbar ħabib tiegħi Bobby. Jien huwa binqattaw ħafna ħin flimkien. Noħorġu ftit għall-arja nilagħbu xi logħba għall-lum. Jew ngħumu xi hawnma. Filgħaxija nintefgħu fuq is-sofa naraw it-television. U kif jaqbadna laċċ, Bobby jixrob l-ilma. Jien nippreferi l-birra. Birra tagħna l-klieb ovvjament, għax l-alkoħol ma nħobbuhx. Lucky Dog, birra nutrittiva, rikka fil-vitamina B u magħmula minn estratti tal-laħam.
Ġeru ġdid fid-dar iġib miegħu ħafna fer u Royal Canin jgħinek sabiex dan il-fer ikun aktar speċjali u fit-tul. Kull kelb għandu jingħata ikel adattat għad-daqs u għall-età tiegħu u dan japplika wkoll għal meta l-kelb ikun għadu ġeru. Royal Canin Mini Junior 33 ikel speċjali għall-klieb ta' bejn ix-xahrejn u l-10 xhur li meta jikbru jibqgħu ta' daqs żgħir. Dan huwa ikel formula speċjali sabiex is-saħħa id-difiżi naturali tal-ġeru filwaqt li jassigura sistema diġestiva perfetta. Id-daqs, il-forma u l-għamla flimkien mal-aroma tal-ingredienti naturali, Royal Canin Mini Junior 33 jirnexxilhom jissodisfaw l-appetit delikat ta' dawn il-ġrievi.
Sajt ta' Triq Zakarija il-Bel Valletta jixtru kull tip ta' deħ, kull tip ta' fidda, kif ukoll mapep, veduti jew kartolini oriġinali ta' Malta, medalji tal-gwerra, il-flus karti ta' Malta u ta' barra kollha li m'għadhomx jintużaw, muniti jew ingotti ta' deħ u fidda kollha. Biex tmorru għand sajt, itħlu mas-sit tat-teatru fid-daħla tal-Bel Valletta. Duru fuq l-ewwel lemin u mbagħad duru fuq l-ewwel xelluka l-ġotri Zakkarija. Fejn il-ħanut ta' sajt taraw it-tabella Side We Buy Gold.
Animal Diaries qed jiġi miġjub lilkom minn Royal Canin, Pavi Supermarket, Pet Love, Dipartiment għall-ħarsin tal-annimali, Bristow Potteries.
Nsellmilkom u nilqakom għal program Animal Diaries l-ewwel wieħed għal din l-iskeda. Niftħu bil-kbir għax illum kien hemm propjament il-konferenza tal-8 hours, 8hours.eu biex tkunu tafu aktar dwar xiex se nitkellmu illum. Għandi rappreżentanti miegħi barranin għandna wkoll lil-Anita preżenti hawnhekk bħall-iskeda li għaddiet u lil-Nina hawnhekk. Illum se nitkellmu dwar it-trasportazzjoni tal-annimali. Forsi ftit taħsbu kemm jgħaddu minn dbatija l-annimali sakemm forsi għal min jikolla ħam jasal fuq il-plattija u l-bicċa laħam, però l-annimali għal min ma jikollx laħam u għal min aħna l-attivisti li naħdmu dejjem favur l-annimali tiġina qudiem wiċċna id-dbatija li jgħaddu. Mela min xiex dbatija jgħaddu, mela il-trakkijiet jitilqu mir-razzett madwar l-Ewropa kollha tiġri din, jitilqu mir-razzett u mbagħad skont id-destinazzjoni jaslu fil-post fejn jiġu maqtula, ġifiri dik dak il-vjaġġ jagħmluh ħajjin. It-trasportazzjoni li ssir mixejn sabiħa kif se naraw minn hawn u ftit ieħor waqt il-filmat u nixtieq niġbed l-attenzjoni minn hu sensittiv għal dawn il-ftipi ta' filmati, niġbdilkom l-attenzjoni li ma segwux il-filmat u tibqgħu tismawna, però l-filmat huwa qasir u se nitkellmu dwar dan. Din hija l-kampanja 8hours.eu biex intejbu il-sitwazzjoni il-trasportazzjoni ta' dawn l-annimali. Mixejn sabiħa is-sitwazzjoni bħalissa. Illum saret il-konferenza, però qabel xejn nixtieq nħalli nistieden naqra lil-Anita miegħi wkoll u ngħidilkom li Janita se tkun maħna idilom nit li se tkun maħna inti.
Barġajna flimkien għattini skeda tal-program Animal Diaries. Jina waqt il-program sen kun edawnek biex nirċivi il-rapporti taqom l-menti dwar l-abbuż tal-annimali. Tistgħu tiktbulna, tistgħu tibqgħu anonimi. Tistgħu tiktbuli fuq anita@animaldiaries.eu jew inkella fuq il-Facebook paġna tagħna Animal Diaries. Tinsewx ukoll il-website tagħna animaldiaries.eu.
Grazzi, Anita, niftħu l-programm tagħna bil-mistiedna hawnhekk u bippjaċir ngħidilkom l-ħdejja għandi MEP minn Danimarka, Mr. Dan Jorgensen. Welcome to Animal Diaries. Anna wkoll.
I haven't got a clue what you just said there,
yes,
but I'm sure it's
you're going to say more than that in English for okay. Sure. Christine Hafner li maħħa se nitkellem ukoll. Christine Hafner hija Anġlu fil-fatt issejjaħ Animal Angels hija parti mill-grupp attivisti tal-annimali li tinvestiga dawn il-każ. Fil-fatt din propjament jisuqu wara dawn it-trakkijiet u jaraw x'hemm fit-trakk f'liema kondizzjoni jinsabu l-annimali. Jinsab magħna wkoll Mr. Adolfo Sansolini, thank you for being here, huwa konsulent u koordinatur għal din il-kampanja 8 Hours, u magħna wkoll Majon Oss lill-promoter tal-konferenza u chairman tal-International Animal Rescue Malta, Max Farrugia, u miegħu se jwaslilkom dak kollu li ngħidu aħna bl-Ingliż bil-Malti ċaru tont ħaniftehmu biex ngħinukom ukoll tkomplu seguna. Dan, I'm going to start with you. First of all, thank you for accepting this. I know you have a very tight schedule and I really appreciate you being here. So, the conference has happened all day long. We spoke a lot. You had a lot of speakers. And what happened so far? You've been on this campaign for a long time. Tell us about it.
Well, basically, the idea behind this campaign is that animals are sentient beings. They can feel pain, they can suffer. And unfortunately, the agricultural sector of Europe seem to ignore this. They treat animals to some extent as if they were machines, just there to produce eggs and meat and fur. And this we see, unfortunately, also when we transport animals. So, today, the situation is that more than 40 million animals are transported on the streets of highways of Europe, many of them for days and days under horrific conditions. Really, this is animal cruelty and it needs to be stopped.
And we're not talking here about hours, we're talking about days at the moment. That's what's
happening. We're
talking about
days. In my opinion, no animal should ever be transported more than 8 hours. Actually, I think that an animal should only be transported to the nearest slaughterhouse.
Exactly.
But, you know, if we had to have a limit, 8 hours would probably be a
okay.
good idea.
Question point in case, why doesn't this happen?
Well, I'm so sorry to say this because I'm here on Malta and you're all so nice people and you're so the hospitality is great and I really like Malta and Maltese people. But I have to tell you, that right now it's the Maltese commissioner, Mr. John Daly, who is blocking. We have more than 1 million signatures. 1,103,243
wow.
people signed this saying, we want this to stop. And we have a majority in the parliament, in the European parliament, 395 members out of 754 says, we need this to stop. But the way legislation is made in the European Union, we need the European Commission to put forward a proposal for us politicians to then adapt it. And Commissioner Dalli, unfortunately, says no, he won't do that.
I was going to ask you later on about his answer.
I'm sorry if I ruined
It's okay. It's all right. But your work hasn't stopped and you've been chasing this. This campaign has been going on. Okay, the conference has been in Malta. Was that the particular reason why it was held in Malta?
Well, that's definitely one of the reasons because, for instance, all the Maltese members of the European Parliament also support this.
Yes.
So, of course, we are hoping that. I don't think John Daly is an evil man. Of course, he's not. But I think that he must be under a lot of pressure from somebody, some very powerful forces in the European Commissioner, in the European Commission, since he doesn't do anything. So what I hope is that our presence here, trying to explain to the interested people here on Malta, what the situation is, that they will help also put pressure on Mr. Dalí. Well, pressure is probably not the right word, but ask Mr. Dalí, please, can you help us stop this suffering of all these animals? Because really, there's no reason for this to happen. Maybe there's some people that are making money on it, but really, should we allow for animals to suffer like
yes.
this? I don't think so.
Excuse me, I must say this in Maltese because we're about to show the filming while we talk with Christine. Sen uru dan il-filmat, jekk intom naqra sensitivi dwar x'qed jiġri hija realtà, m'aħna qed nuru xej ta' gideb, però attenti sen nuru l-filmat. Issa, Christine. You are an investigator, you work for Animals Angels. How long have you been doing this for?
For 10 years.
For 10 years.
Yeah.
And what exactly do you do? Because I know what you do, but it's nice to share with our viewers. Your yeah. work is amazing.
So we are really focused on the welfare of animals during transport. This is the only issue we are specialized in. My colleagues and me, we're actually on the road, and this is also our motto, which says we are with the animals. So we're actually monitoring the animal transports, mainly long-distance animal transports. Long distance always more than 8 hours,
mm-hmm.
But also short distance. And we are simply watching what's going on in practice. Because there's a regulation, but very often this regulation is not respected. And even if it is, the longer the journey takes, the more the animals suffer. Then if there's something bad going on, we try to call the authorities and also try to give some help.
So let's put it straight into words. So you actually chase the lorries. As we speak, we are seeing the filming here, the feature. These trucks, you follow these trucks on motorways and see and check if the animals are well kept, basically. Am I right?
Exactly. We follow the trucks, and we are also, for example, this is an Italian port where we waited in the port for the trucks to arrive, or we are at borders.
As we can see, that there's no headroom, there's no headspace, and that's, are there any regulations being respected here, as we, obviously not?
There's no headroom, yes, which also hinders the proper ventilation, which is mm-hmm. very bad for the animals, especially in summer when it's hot. Well, the regulation says there needs to be sufficient space for the animals, but sufficient is not really defined, so it depends a lot on the interpretation of the police or the veterinarian who's checking the truck. Of course, for us, this was insufficient
yes.
space, yeah.
Yes. Thank you, Christine. For now, I would like to speak with Adolfo. Adolfo, you were the speaker this morning. You know, you have all the knowledge about this campaign and what's going on in the EU as a coordinator and as a consultant. Your opinion about today's conference and what's been going on so far is enough said, you know, we've seen the filming.
Yes, I think it's been very important to be here today. We've been chasing Commissioner Dalí for quite a while. When we handed in the 1,100,000 signatures that Jorgensen referred to, Commissioner Dalí said, well, okay, I'm committing, and that was at the end of a long meeting trying to get something real out of typical politician language, not saying really something. Real.
Not typical for all politicians.
For some, that's
for
true.
Some
that's true. Of bad politicians' yes. language, trying not to say anything. And we chased him to say, okay, are you going to make a proposal to change rules that either have not worked for 20 years or in some cases we've shown evidence that they cannot possibly work?
But if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Dalí as well said that the transportation will be one of the many issues that they're going to tackle after this campaign. Am
yes.
I right?
Our concern is that John Dalí says that he's very concerned, but he's the commissioner who's got the power to table a proposal.
Yes.
Nobody else can.
Yes.
So I can be concerned, you can be concerned, but he's the commissioner. He cannot just be concerned, he should take action.
Yes.
So what he said today, I mean, trying to deny again that he committed in front of cameras on the 7th of June to present a proposal for a communication for a legislative proposal to change the rules on transport, he then denied that. And today he came, we asked for a real answer, and at the end, basically, he left the conference without committing to anything. In the meanwhile, as we can see, tens of millions of animals are suffering.
Yes,
so we
yes.
are, to us, it's very important.
Well, he referred to the situation as not proved, and they need to be scientifically, the situation needs to be scientifically proven that the animals are suffering. Am I right? Correct me if I'm wrong.
That's what he said.
How can this be scientifically proved? Because we can see with our own eyes that it's not the right.
Well, exactly.
But partly it can.